Students, the next problem is find the Fourier series of f of x of period 2L and is defined as f of x equal to L minus x, 0 is less than x, x is less than or equal to 1, and f of x equal to 0, 1 is less than or equal to x, x is less than 2L. Here, deduce the sum to infinity as sigma n is equal to 0 to infinity 1 divided by 2n plus 1 the whole square. Now, procedurally, we shall go step by step. The step 1 is to write the Fourier series expansion of f of x. The Fourier series expansion of f of x is a0 by 2 plus sigma n is equal to infinity a n cos n pi x divided by L plus sigma n is equal to infinity b n sin n pi x divided by L. Let this be equation number 1. And the Fourier series expansion of f of x, the Fourier coefficients a0, an and bn are to be found out. The step number 2 is to find a0. The step number 2 is to find a0. A0 can be defined by the formula 1 by L integral of 0 to 2L f of x into dx. Now the function has been defined between two intervals, that is between 0 and 1 and 1 and 2L. So we have to write the expansion for the two intervals, that is 1 by L, the first interval is 0 to L, it is not 1, it is L. The first interval is 0 to L, the next interval is not 1, it is L, L to 2L, and we have to define the function between the interval 0 to L, it is integral of 0 to L f of x dx plus the second interval is between L to 2L, that is the expansion is integral of L to 2L f of x dx. Now a0 is equal to 1 by L integral of 0 to L. You have to substitute f of x between the interval 0 to L. Between the interval 0 to L, f of x is equal to L minus x. So L minus x of dx plus 0. Between the interval L to 2L, the function f of x is equal to 0. That is why 0 has been substituted here. That is equal to 1 by L. Now you need to differentiate L minus x. It is of the model x power n. So x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 it is. And it is L minus x the whole squared. 1 plus 1 it is equal to 2. Therefore it is L minus x the whole squared divided by 1 plus 1 is 2. And the content in the bracket differentiated, and the differentiation should divide the integration. So now differentiate the content inside the bracket. It is differentiation of minus x is minus 1. So already there is a plus 2 in the denominator. So minus 1 into plus 2, it is equal to minus 2 at the denominator. Now substitute the limits between 0 to L. And we have to substitute the upper limit. It is L minus L. It is L minus L the whole square. L minus L the whole square, and the next limit is L, and the next limit is, it is L this is L minus 0. L minus 0. Now substituting the limits, L minus L the whole square minus of 0 the whole square. L minus 0 the whole square. L minus L is 0, it is 0 squared minus L squared divided by 2L, and it will become minus L squared divided by 2L, and minus of minus will become plus, and this is L divided by 2. Now step number 3 is to find out AN. We know that AN is 1 by L integral of 0 to 2L f of x into cos n pi x divided by L into x of dx, which is equal to 1 by L. So we have two intervals, one is 0 to L, another one is L to 2L. So we have to define the function, the expansion between these two intervals. So the expansion is, the formula is written as 1 by L integral of 0 to L f of x cos n pi x by L, L to integral of L to 2L f of x into cos n pi x divided by L into, now it is written as 1 by L, the function between 0 to L is L minus f of x is L minus x, so L minus x is substituted here, into cos n pi x divided by L into dx, and between the limit L to 2L f of x is equal to 0, so 0 is substituted here, and this is integral of uv dx model. So 1 by L, the integral of uv dx model by using Bernoulli's expansion, it is u into, that is L minus x into v1, that is integration of v. So this is u, this is taken as u, this is taken as v, and the integration of v cos n pi x divided by L sin n pi x divided by L divided by n pi divided by L. So the term in the denominator n pi divided by L is subtraction of n pi x divided by L. The differentiation of n pi x divided by L is n pi divided by L. So it is to divide the integration minus u dash into v2, and the u dash is minus is put here, and u dash is the differentiation of u with respect to x, that is the first derivative. Now the second term, u dash into v1, u dash is the first derivative of u, it is the u is L minus x, differentiation of L is 0, differentiation of minus x is minus 1, and v2 is the integration of v1, integration of v1 is sin n pi x divided by L whole divided by n pi divided by L. The integration of sine is minus cos, so it is here minus cos, minus sine is here. Minus cos of n pi x divided by L whole divided by n squared pi squared divided by L. So the n squared pi squared divided by L is obtained by the differentiation of n pi x divided by L with respect to x. There will be two terms, n pi divided by l into n pi divided by l. It will become n squared pi squared divided by l. Now you need to substitute the limits between 0 to l. Now you look into the terms and first seek the opportunity to make these terms equal to 0. First let us look into the sine term, and sine n pi is equal to 0 already we know. By substituting the upper limit in the sine term, so you observe the sine n pi x divided by l, you are substituting x is equal to l, l and the denominator l will get cancelled, it is sine n pi, it is equal to sine 0, sine 0 is 0. Now you substitute the lower limit 0, so sine n pi x divided by l will be equal to sine n pi into 0 divided by l, it will become sine 0, it is also equal to 0. Now you need not bother about this becoming g the lower limit. Now you look into the cos term, and first let you substitute the upper limit. When you substitute the upper limit, it will become minus cos n pi x divided by l. So substitute x, l for x, so it is n pi l divided by l, so l and l will get cancelled, it will become cos of n pi. It's already there in front, so it will be written as minus of cos n pi, and the l in the denominator will go to the numerator, and this will become l by n square pi square. And when you substitute the lower limit 0 and you are substituting for x, so n plus 0 is equal to 1 and minus of minus will become 1. And we have taken l divided by n squared pi squared outside the bracket. So l squared, l by n squared pi squared into minus cos n pi plus 1. This will be written as l divided by n squared pi squared, and plus 1 is written first, 1 minus cos n pi is generally written as minus 1 to the power n. When n is equal to even, minus 1 to the power even number will become plus 1, 1 minus 1 now become 0, so an is equal to 0 when n is even. And when n is odd, so to the odd power is minus 1, minus of minus 1 will become plus 1, so it will become 2l divided by n squared pi squared when n is odd. So we have now an also. Now step number 4, to find out the value of bn, bn is equal to 0 to 2l f of x into sine n pi x divided by l into dx. We already know that the function is defined between two intervals, well, another one is from l to 2l. So we have to write the formula for the two intervals. It is 1 by l integral of 0 to l f of x into sine n pi x divided by l into dx, plus for the second interval f of x into sine n pi x divided by l dx. Now 1 by l integral of 0 to l, between 0 to l the function f of x is equal to l minus x, so l minus x is substituted, into sine n pi x divided by l into dx. And between the limit l to 2l the function f of x is equal to 0, therefore the next term will become 0. This is equal to 1 by l, and the term l minus x is taken as u, and sine n pi x divided by l is taken as v, and it is integral of uv dx model. And for uv dx model the formula is u into v1 minus u dash into, so it is 1 by l u into l minus x into v1 is the integration of sine n pi x divided by l is cos n pi x divided by L divided by n pi divided by L minus u dash into v2 minus u dash is differentiation of L is 0, differentiation of minus x is minus 1, it is written as minus 1 here. The integration of cos n pi x divided by L is sin n pi x divided by L whole divided by L. Already there is an n pi divided by L, so the denominator will become n squared pi squared divided by L squared. And now the limits are substituted to L, and when you are substituting the upper limit L in sin x term, it will the sin n pi x divided by L will become sin n pi, it is equal to 0. When you substitute 0, the lower limit also, sin n pi x divided by L is becoming 0, it is sin of 0 is equal to 0, so you need not bother about the sin term. And when you substitute now for the cos x term, when you substitute the upper limit, the first term will become L minus of L, it will become 0. So when the substitution for L, it is becoming 0. Next you will substitute the lower limit to 0, it is L minus 0, so L already minus of cos n pi 0, cos 0 it will become, it is becoming minus 1, and minus of minus 1 will become minus plus. There is already an L, and L and the L outside the bracket in the denominator will get cancelled, and here the L term in the numerator of cos n pi x will go to the denominator of cos n pi x will go to the numerator, so the net term will become L by n pi into cos n pi. And when it is cos n pi, so for odd number of n, cos n pi is equal to minus 1, for even number of n, cos n pi is equal to plus 1, so it is generally written as bn is equal to divided by n pi. Now the next step is step number 5, write the Fourier series expansion for f of x. So f of x is equal to a0 by 2, and a0 is L by 2. Now a0 by 2 will become L by 4 plus sigma n is equal to 1 comma 3 comma 5, because find the value for an for odd numbers of n, because for even numbers of n an is equal to 0. That is why we have written for the odd numbers of n is equal to 1 comma 3 comma 5 to infinity, 2L divided by n squared pi squared into cos n pi x divided by L plus n is equal to 1 to infinity minus 1, that is you substitute the value for bn into sin n pi x or n into L divided by n pi into sin n pi x divided by L. Now it will become L by 4 plus 2L by pi squared sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity. So here n is changed from odd to, n is changed from odd, n is equal to 1, you come to the point of note, and when sigma n is equal to odd to infinity is changed to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity, n is to be replaced by 2n minus 1. So here in the formula, n squared is replaced by 2n minus 1 the whole square into cos n pi x divided by L plus L by pi sigma 1 to infinity minus 1 power n divided by n into sin n pi x divided by L. Now step number 6, the value of f of x at x is equal to 0 between 0 comma 2L is f of the Fourier series expansion at x is equal to 0 should be equated to the average of the value of the function at x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 2L. It is f of 0 plus f of 2L divided by 2. And f of 0 is equal to L, f of 2L is equal to 0. It is L plus 0 divided by 2, which is equal to L by 2. Now, find out the value for the Fourier series expansion of f of x at x is equal to 0. And it is L by 4 plus 2L by pi squared sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 by 2n minus 1 the whole square. The second term will become 0 because the value for the Fourier series expansion is found out. Sine n pi x will become sine n pi into 0. It will become sine 0 is equal to 0. The second term is becoming 0. Now it will be written as 2l divided by pi squared. Now we are changing n to 1. So n to n equal to 0 to infinity. When sigma n is equal to r to infinity, it is changed to n is equal to 0 to infinity, n is to be replaced by 2n plus 1. It is written here as 1 by 2n plus 1 the whole square. And the L by 4 is moved to the right hand side. Already there is a term at the right hand side, L by 2. So L by 2 minus L by 4, it is equal to L by 4. And rearranging the equation, we shall get the final deduction, sigma 0 to infinity 1 divided by 2n plus 1 the whole squared is equal to pi squared by 8. The students are requested to be careful changing infinity to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity, and here n is to be replaced by 2n minus 1. When it is required to be changed, sigma n is equal to r to infinity to sigma n is equal to 0 to infinity, in that case n is to be replaced by 2n plus 1. So in the problem it has been asked the defined between 0 to infinity. So n is to be replaced by 2n plus 1 when we are converting the function the sigma n is equal to r to infinity.